went to Disneyland yesterday. 39 years ago, after accompanying Becky on her high school grad night to Magic Kingdom, I wrote something like this. Disneyland is a cream puff dream beyond compare. Those words stuck in my brain ever since, and I find now that they are truer than any form I could ever make. Disneyland is a cream puff dream beyond compare. I wonder if they know all about us, the lonely middle-aged men who come to the Magic Kingdom alone, desperately trying to recapture our lost youth from the 1960s and 1950s, lonely coyote baby boomers wandering the paths with no cameras to record our adventures, no children clinging to our hands, no women or boy dates by our side, alone, purely alone. All the giant costumed creatures leave us alone. We want no pictures with Goofy. We generate no smiles. We ride the rides of, attractions. There are no rides. There be no rides in Disneyland. We ride the attractions alone. Taking up the benches built for two or three or four with children, an empty space to the left of us, an empty space to the right of us, we sit. And then, at last, we smile. It's still the same as it was 50 years ago. In my case, however, it was slightly different because it was my birthday. And I got in free, and I was wearing one of those big pins, those big round, happy birthday, your name here buttons pinned to my chest, or rather, pinned to my shirt front pocket. I'm still wearing the same shirt. I won't take it off. Oh, I had so much fun. It was different because of that big damn button which I refused to take off. Because of the happiness identity tag. Everyone, every 5 minutes, would stop and say, "Happy birthday, Daniel!" Often, it was a worker. A cast member. Who would smile and greet me and wish me a special day. They even sounded sincere about it. Like it was a special moment for them. In the happiest place on earth. And it got so that just ordinary tourists, guests, at the Magic Kingdom would shout out my name from the lines and the crowds. Happy birthday, Daniel. And I would, of course, answer very, thank you very much. But best of all, when someone else with a big birthday button pinned to his or her bosom shirt front would laugh and shout to me, and I'd shout back to them, "Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Oh yes, how delightful, how infectious, how contagious! How contagiously and ridiculously happy and joyful and fun!" Like I told you, Disneyland is still a cream puff dream. Mwah. Beyond compare. Especially if you don't pay the $72 to get in. I also find there's a converse corollary to the vaunted Disneyland syndrome. The Disneyland syndrome is familiar to anyone who has been divorced. Typically, in common parlance, the Disneyland syndrome means that divorced mothers have to take care of the children during the weekdays and struggle with all the day-to-day realities of school, sports, friends, meetings, mealtimes, doctors, dentists, clothes, shopping, homework, all the rest of reality. But weekend fathers get to take the kids off to Disneyland or the zoo or just the park to enjoy a day off. Divorced daddies thus often become the good old boys from Disneyland, while mommies are transformed into the Wicked Witch of Ugly Reality du jour. The converse corollary, I tell you now, is something I discovered yesterday within the gates of Disneyland itself. Simply by observing hundreds of thousands of mommies and daddies and their children, I quickly began to notice that moms do more screaming and bitching than dads do. Do you want a timeout? Don't make me hurt you. Do you want to go home? Shut up and sit there and be good, etc. Or maybe daddies hide it better. Maybe that phenomenon of women coordinating their periods together was taking place on a sudden mass scale, and every mother in the park suddenly was suffering premenstrual syndrome, PMS, all together. Now yell, scream, bitch at the kids. I should shut up. I should fut the shuck up. What do I know about it? I'm a man. I don't know nothing. I don't even have to put up with lines for the toilets. Or at least usually.